We are at our 8th annual Manufacturing Expo. I am the president and CEO of the East County Economic Development Council, and this is the manufacturing event we hold every year. This is our 8th annual expo, and we look forward to continuing this on and on and making it better every year. It's the only type of expo in Southern California like this. And so if you're interested in making a good living wage, check out manufacturing. That's the way to go.
I think you need to identify that area you're most interested in. You think there's a potential maybe for a career in that, and then pursue certifications, education, whatever you can do, internships, get involved, make relationships with people who already do that job and ask for their advice.
There's so many different careers in manufacturing. Specifically at Taylor Guitars, we have 23 different departments that you could come to work for us. It's not only building our products, but it's also sales, marketing, finance, research and development, engineering. All great careers for someone to have.
With City Community College, and we take a bunch of engineering courses. We do different like model sketching, stuff like that. But then recently we started working on electric guitars. So we're building those from scratch, and we have a blank piece, and we can either pick from like a normal body design that is already made, or we can custom design. This is a custom design body. And we kind of just go through the process of building our own guitar that we get to keep for later on.
I've got three different classes. So in the morning I have my construction class. So they'll be doing anywhere from learning about different trades like carpentry, electricity, plumbing. And my third period class is my capstone class. That's the third year that they take three-year program. And they're doing right now, they're building cabinetry, and then they'll eventually go into guitar building.
What we learn in here, I know that I will be able to use it when I want to have a job or when I go off into college, because some kids go into college not knowing how to use SolidWorks or not knowing how to program CROD or not knowing how to like speak to elders or people that are older than you to try to get something done.
Today in our class in the Grande Foundation Manufacturing Academy, we're going over advanced blueprint reading and math, such as trigonometry, true position, things like that, that these folks would need in a manufacturing environment or inspection environment.
I was awake. When I wake up, I was surprised. I feel happy. I want to tell you something I was thinking about. Me. I was awake. I'm so happy. What's that? Is that people? Do you want to join me? When I clap my hand, I'm happy. Everyone celebrate. I'm so happy. I'm smart happy. Everyone say goodbye. Everyone feel happy. But I want to tell you something about that. When I tell you something, me, here we are. I was awake again. But I think what's that? Is that Genshin Impact characters? I'm so happy they want to join me again. Everyone celebrate. Either Paimon and me. Everyone say goodbye. the people they finally feel happy. There's one they felt something was wrong. But I was wanna tell you something. I'm not happy anymore. I need to tell you, me, I was awake again. I saw people, they wanna go over there. You take me. You don't wanna take me to place. After that, people are not happy. They're not happy anymore. They want to leave me alone. He left me. Everyone trying to leave. I'm so lonely. I'm so lonely. After that, when I wake up, and I'm still alone. I'm so lonely anymore.
Hey, my name is Jack, and this is part two of making brownies with Yusuf, and I'm gonna do my part now. First step is to preheat your oven to 325 Fahrenheit. Second step is to add 2/3 cups of vegetable oil and 2/3 of water and 2 eggs. Next, you put in your brownie mix. And now you mix. And now you put your cooking spray on your pan. Now you put your brownie mix into your pan. After that, you put your pan inside the oven for 29 minutes at 325 degrees Fahrenheit.
Hello, my name is River. I'm redrawing a piece I made 5 to 6 years ago.
Welcome to the first annual cooking episode with your host, Christian, and
co-host, Elijah.
We're going to be making a hash brown and eggs. We're going to peel these potatoes.
Yeah, see that? See that?
Yeah. All right, so now we're gonna shred these potatoes into here.
First time doing this ever.
Bro, wait, did something just...
No.
I something just broke off.
Five minutes later.
All right, so after you're done rinsing it, this is what your water should look like.
Have to let this dry for about 10, 15 minutes.
You do?
Yeah.
All right, so, you know, once we get these all dried, I'm gonna add some vegetable oil, a generous amount, so.
Oh,
yeah. All right, now, after that, you're gonna add maybe like 4 sticks of butter. Like,
all right.
Or, you know, like, 18 ounces of butter.
All right, yep, that's good. Oh, I hate black pepper.
You don't like black pepper?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Don't, that's good, that's enough.
That was
that's
enough.
Enough, that's enough.
Right, watch me season this.
Okay, yeah. Great with everything.
Now we're just gonna let this cook for about 5 minutes with this comedically large lid.
5 minutes, exactly 5 minutes.
So,
no more. No.
You know, right now, 5 minutes is gonna be over, and we're back. So it's smelling good.
But don't you? You have to flip the whole thing.
Yeah. Look at that.
Good that's, luck with that.
It's gonna flip.
No, don't do it.
I do double spatula.
Two hands. And the real good cameraman. Boom.
Oh.
Do you want another 5 minute?
I think we're gonna have to wait.
All right. So let me.
Hello there. Okay. Now I think it's been about 5 minutes. We're gonna put this. This hash browns on a plate. Let's go actual. We'll get a bigger one. Here we go. See, I don't need to like Christian. Ready?
Okay, now that the star is back, because everyone else hates Elijah.
Okay.
We got the eggs, and we're gonna...
Why'd you put the... What's that?
We're gonna use the same pan, because we're lazy. Don't be like us.
You're that skilled.
I don't think so right now. Yeah.
Yikes. Yeah. I do.
Hello, throw this away.
Please.
Follow me. So, this is obviously my fridge, you know? I definitely know where the cheese is.
Hurry.
Where's the cheese?
It's right in front of you.
Here it is.
Yeah.
Yes. Back. We'll show you when this is... that's an ugly-ass dog. We'll see when the cheese is melted. Is our cheese melted? So it's basically melted. Now that we have our ingredients, we have to assemble our knockoff McMuffin. Our breads should be ready. Okay. All right.
Since Christian did his hash brown first, we're gonna be different. Oh yeah, we're putting condiments. Most definitely.
I'll put ketchup.
I don't think that's gonna be a good happy face.
No.
I don't know if that's a happy face.
All right, so I think Elijah's gonna kick the camera now, and we're gonna see you guys in the taste test.
Yo,
we're here with the taste test.
Yep. Yo, get off.
Annual taste test.
See that? Oh, I'm here.
This is mine.
The better one.
What?
Up, bro.
kind of wish I was better at this guitar. I mean, it's such a cool instrument, but I'm so bad. Look at this band. God, this looks so cool. I wish I could be in that band. I love this drummer. God, I want to be in this band. How do I do that? If I was just a better guitar player, they'd probably want me in the band. I wonder if I could ask them if I could join the band. I'm going to reach out to them and I'm going to ask them. Hey, I checked out your band online and I really want to know if you need a guitar player. I'd love to try it out.
Well, I don't know, man. You gotta try out. Did you bring your guitar or something? Like, we have to do some tryouts first.
I do have my guitar. I have it right over here. Do you want to listen to what I can do?
Yeah, let's see what you got.
Okay.
Show me what you got.
Dude, you suck. Wait, this is the best part coming up.
It's a camera
people. I tried so hard. Why did you say I suck? I'll show those guys. I'm gonna practice so hard, and I'm gonna become the best guitar player they've ever seen. They're gonna want me in their band. I'll practice all day and all night. Man, it feels so good. I came from nothing. I couldn't play at all, and I practiced day and night, and now I have my own band! Thank you.
guys, my name is Sahar and I have two special guests with me. My older brother,
Slamon.
And my younger brother,
Sahil.
And we have three options with a drink, three chips that we have never tried before. And we have this. I can't read the names, but they're Lee's. Cheetos, chicken flavor, and crawfish flavor, Lee's. So let's start with this one. It's tomato flavor, I think.
Stop laughing, bro.
Okay. Get one. Don't try it yet. Get one.
Yeah.
No, don't try it yet. Stop. And I get one. Okay, ready, guys? One, two, three. Okay.
This is
like already one out of ten.
Zero.
I rated a 5.
5.6.
You're very specific. It just like tastes like tomato. Okay.
Imagine my mind. I give it a 4.
4?
Yeah.
This is the second one. It's Cheetos. Give one. It's chicken flavor.
Oh.
I know you like protein.
Let me see how much protein it has.
It's not time to be slamming. You're not supposed to try it. You gotta wait for me.
I didn't try it.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. It's not that bad. This tastes like the cheese one. I'll give this a 7.5 out of 10.
A 6. A 9.
A 9? Very high rating. And last, not the lastly, but we got crawfish. I'm not too sad about this one. Not a big fan of crawfish. Wait, we're not trying this yet. Doesn't smell too appetizing.
Oh, I don't want to try it.
You have to try it. Ready? One. You want to smell it? Okay, 1, 2, 3. Ew. I give it a...
Can you read the ingredients?
I'll give it a 2 out of 10.
Negative 2. 0.
Okay. Let's move to the side on this. This is supposed to be Coke. We got our cup. Okay, I guess. This is Coke, but I think it's... I don't want to be offensive, but I think it's Japanese.
It's Chinese.
It smells like Coke. Move your hand. Okay. Ready, guys? Go. You drink the whole thing. Okay. Stop. I'll give it a 9 out of 10. I actually really like this one. What about you?
7. 7.
It's like sparkling water mixed with Coke. Okay, so which one was your favorite? This one, the tomato, or the crawfish?
To be honest, none of them.
I agree.
Which one would you prefer to eat out of all the three?
The soda.
The soda? Okay.
No, this one right here.
The tomato one?
Yeah, that's pretty good.
You give that a very low rating. You give it a 4.
Oh, I changed my mind.
They don't like it, but they would eat it. Okay. This will be the end of our film. Thank you for watching. Any last word?
Peace out.
How about you?
No.
Okay. Bye, guys.
Jet. All the females for the woman. Is it the red one?
Yeah.
Hi, Mac. I'm here with
Jimena Quintero.
And I have a couple questions for you about Live at Lunch.
Okay.
What is, you worked Live at Lunch before, yes?
Yeah.
Okay. What is some of the jobs that you've done?
Well, I've done mostly PA, but I did do video once, which is like when you record in the assemblies and then it shows like on the big screen.
Yeah.
So I've done honestly just those two jobs. Not having social anxiety, because like a year ago, I literally could not be in such a big group of people. I'ma tell you one time. So I feel like it helped me be a little bit more social and just not be socially awkward. So you do have to be working with other people.
For the first time in like touring with different cities was an accomplishment for me. It is something I'll always be proud of, and I'm excited to go back again. Yeah, we're heading to New Zealand, December 7th.
Thank you.
Hello, guys. So, I'm with Sahar, and we just got
birria taco.
Mm-hmm. And we're about to do a little open, a little box if you want to show.
Let's show them the first lick.
Ooh!
Okay, take your tacos.
Period. I like that they don't double tortilla.
Taste test the lemons.
Let's see if they're good lemons.
And good chili right there.
Oh, and then we got a salsa. This is a cup of only hot sauce.
Oh, let me put some. Let me move my AirPods because it's in the way.
You're good, boo.
Yeah, let's try it because I'm not being patient no more.
Okay, sorry.
Cheers. Oh.
It tastes like a goat.
Maybe it is.
We're eating a goat. That's sad. That's so sad.
I don't care.
That's so sad. What if it was a baby goat? They're so cute.
And they're so good.
This girl, y'all.
Actually, I'm gonna take the salsa home to myself.
Do you want to? Go. I was gonna ask you if you wanted to.
Yeah, I was gonna too.
You're so stupid. You're too funny.
Bye.
Hi everyone, my name is Lola.
And I'm Luna, and here's a date of both of our lives here.
I'm Lola, I am 3 years old.
Wait, where's the camera?
And,
hey, what are you doing?
She loves the attention.
Hey,
in fact, Luna over here is actually my daughter. I had 6 of those puppies, and she's just one of them that we kept.
You heard that right. I was the prettiest, and I was the nicest, and now we're here. I wonder what my other siblings are doing.
On regular days, we just like to hang out and sleep. But today, Luna's been so crazy because I put on a diaper for her. And she needs it for her health. And look at her. You're making a fool out of yourself, Luna. Like, You don't have to be that dramatic. Like, it's just a diaper. You need it. What? Leave my toe alone. You know, you're so extra at times. Like, you need to calm down. Calm down, girl. Hey, no, cut. Well, we don't have anything else to add. So enjoy the next couple of clips of Luna and Lola Core.
Y'all better miss me.
We'll be experiencing some turbulence, so buckle up.
What the? Is something wrong, sir? There's a man hanging on the wing and his skin is rotting. That's crazy, but open your window and toss this knife at him.
Attention all passengers, due to an unfortunate circumstance of a man dangerously hanging onto the plane, which I was just informed of, we are going to stop this flight and postpone it until further notice. I would like to apologize for this inconvenience.
I guess I'll have to wait another few days before I see my family again.
We are losing control. The engine on the left wing is now destroyed. Prepare for a water landing.
Oh God, I caused this. It was all my fault.
Six and a half hours later.
I can't believe I got arrested for tax evasion. That's fake news.
And I got arrested for existing.
Well, isn't this great? The creator of this project arrested me and made me share a cell with Ice Cream Joe, Towers, Obunga, and this baked potato over here.
Wow! The prison food here sucks. There is no ice cream. Spongy, Spongy, help me.
I got arrested because Obamacare failed.
Okay, you guys, here is your prison food.
Ew, that's not chocolate chippy ice cream. What?
Calm down, Joe. It's not even that bad.
You probably think it's not that bad because the food you make in Trump Tower is dog water.
Hello, son.
Who are you?
I have a plan. That is fake news. This is a maximum security prison. Go back to the Wild West where you belong.
Have some goddamn faith!
Here is some paper so you guys don't die of boredom. Jeez.
Oh, this is good. So we can write an escape plan, but we don't have a pencil.
Oh, here, I have one.
How in the fuck?
I am a magical politician.
Yeah, we get it, Joe. You're magical.
Okay, now we should just wait for dinner. The guards usually bring our food with sporks. Use them to cut a hole in the wall to escape.
Now how in the hell will we do that? They are plastic.
Don't question it, baked potato. It's cartoon logic. It was the creator's idea.
Anywho, now let's get out of here.
Nom.
Nom, 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 nom.
Damn, you eat more than me.
He ate the tray too.
You only had two lines, bruh.
Because the creators forgot about me?
Anyways, we cut a hole through this wall. Now we have to crawl up this vent.
This is working tremendously.
Hey, that's my line.
Nothing can go wrong.
Oh God, my stomach, it hurts.
Oh God, don't even think about it. Stop it, Sleepy Joe, before I beat you in the 2024 elections and ban ice cream forever.
This is going to be worse than Obamacare.
This is going to be worse than September 2000.
Oh God, Mr. Ford and the presidents are out of their cells. Hey, sound the alarm.
Well, great. They know we're escaping. Let's hurry up.
Oh no. They are going to look for us all. I don't want to go back to jail again. I want mommy. I want Spongy.
I am not going to go back. When I get to my classroom, I will make everyone sign up for presentations because of this, and I will make the creator of this project present first.
Okay, we're finally free.
Oh no, the police are after us.
I have a plan.
You always got a plan, Dutch?
Oh my God, Horsey!
Bruh, ain't no way.
Quick, get on the wagon. The cops are getting closer.
Dutch even gave us some revolvers so we can hold off the cops much easier.
Finally, we escaped the police.
Hey, can we stop at Spongy's house?
No, Joe, we're wanted men. We are not stopping at SpongeBob's house.
No!
Calm down, Joe. We are going to hide in Air Force One.
No, we should hide at the Obamacare Hospital. Joe can't really handle the stairs for Air Force One.
I hate you guys.
We should hide in...
No!
I know what you're gonna say, Bush.
Let's go to Obama's hospital.
Why can't we hide at the White House or my classroom?
Because they know us very well. Mr. Ford, you're literally a teacher, so the cops will be searching your classroom for you. Just don't let Joe near any stairs or any ice cream.
I hate you all. I should have stayed home with Spongy.
Oh, Spongy, you're here. I missed you so much.
Okay, Trump, I think we've hurt his feelings too much.
Oh, is that a red button? What does this big red button that says nuke do?
Biden, no, don't press the red button.
Mr. B6000, Mr. B6000, yeah, you know his name. He changed it once or twice, but I think it's here to stay. His thumbnails, well, they made it paint. But if you ask me, I think they're kind of quaint. Mr. B6000.
Hi, everybody. My name is Mitzi. I'm a cow, as you can somewhat tell, and this is my first video. I'm like a beginner fursuit artist, and I really love making fursuit heads. There's been multiple times where I've stopped myself from making a million heads at once, because it's awesome. I'm having like so much fun doing this, but this is my first video. I just wanted to introduce myself. Yeah, I'm a cow. I'm like happy cow. Not much to me. I like video games. I like art, as you can tell. I like making things with my hands or my hooves. My hair fluff. I like my hair fluff. Just a chill cow. Just chilling.
Hello, my name is Yusuf. Today I'm going to be making brownies with Jack. This is part one.
Alright, step one of making brownies. We're going to preheat it for 350 and for 25 minutes. Okay, so for the second step, you need 2/3 of oil and 1/4 of water with 2 eggs.
And we're gonna need another cup of oil.
Alright, so I need one more cup of water. Now we're gonna whisk it. Alright, for the next step, we're gonna put brownie mix. Now we mix it. Alright, now I'm gonna spray it with oil so it doesn't get sticky. Alright, now we, for the next step, we pour the brownie mix. And now we're gonna heat it up for at 350 Fahrenheit for 29 minutes. Alright, so far we have 4 minutes, 30 seconds left. This is what we have so far. You can see, it's almost done.
Hello, Tayo!
Teo, what's up, Teo?
Good morning, Mr. Ford.
Don't you know I'm a yellow Honda?
Well, why don't they call you Mr. Honda?
Good one, Teo. Anyways, check out these sweet rims.
Those look like they were expensive.
Shiny!
Wow.
Watch out, you slow pokes. Big red coming through.
Look out! Big Red almost took our side mirrors out.
Oh, sorry, didn't see you guys.
You were going so fast, my eyes were spinning!
Ha ha ha, sorry about that, it's just so hard for me to drive slow.
Speeding is dangerous, you know.
So dangerous!
Then a little race wouldn't scare you then.
Laugh out loud, yeah, right. I'm the fastest Honda out there.
Okay, see you at the end. I'm winning.
Let's go.
Are you mad you're not as fast as me?
This will be easy.
Zoom! Ah, I'm scared for them.
Tired now.
Told you were no match for Big Red.
What a lovely day!
What a lovely day.
Whoa!
Where did that come from? Again, what is happening?
Let's get them!
I need to get them.
I wasn't trying anyways.
Hey, that was not okay. This is not a racetrack. They should know better.
Are you guys out of your mind? This is illegal.
I'll get it done tonight. I promise. Just, I swear. Buzzing. I might be hallucinating. It won't be too long. I'm not going to stay up late. I'll get it done tonight. I promise. Just, I swear.
What's up, guys? And today I'm going to be teaching you how to make my Subway sandwich. So first, we're gonna start off by washing our hands. On washing and drying your hands, you wanna go ahead and put gloves on. And then, after you put your gloves on, you're gonna go ahead and grab a parchment paper, and you're gonna go ahead and decide what kind of bread you want. My favorite, we're only gonna do half, because why not? Alright, you're going to take your knife and cut it, put the knife down, and then you're going to decide what you want. What am I feeling today? We'll go with, how about steak? Let's do steak. So you're going to take a scoop of your steak and lay it right in the middle. And then you can go ahead and pick whatever cheese you want. I prefer the shredded cheese. Just lay it on top. Just like that. And then if you wanted to toast it, you can go ahead and toast it. So after you have taken it out, it should look something like this with the cheese all melted. And I go ahead and start off with a little bit of lettuce. I can some tomatoes. I put some onions and bell peppers, and that's basically it for that. I add some black olives, they're really good. Some banana peppers, if you don't know what these are, you need to start eating them. More banana peppers, because why not? Some pickles. And then for the sauces, most important part, I do the Baja Chipotle. Probably not saying it right, but it's cool. Ranch, just a little bit. And then the buffalo, which is actually really good. We all know that. Sometimes I do like rustic garlic aioli or some mayo, but not today. We're gonna hit it with some oil, some salt and pepper. We can also throw some parmesan cheese on there, which is like really good. And that's basically it. Oh, and then you're gonna go ahead and wrap it, which just pick it up, make sure you close it off. I'm gonna go ahead and just take it off. You place it right in the front, you roll forward, and then you roll your left in, roll forward, right in, and then just continue all the way forward. And then you guys
You got your perfect little salad. Thank you for watching my video.
Hey, my name is Genevieve. Today is October 31st, 2023. Today we are doing our Halloween live at lunch. As you guys can see, I'm dressed up as a referee. And so now I'm going to show you guys some clips of our event.
When the night was full of terror, and your eyes were filled with tears, when you had not
Hey, yo, what's wrong, man? You okay?
Bro, I've been feeling depressed, and I've been feeling lost lately, man. I don't know what to do, bro.
Well, what's wrong? Well, look, before you continue, I know you're having ups and downs lately, because mm-hmm. you said over the years. I have this Bible with me, and I've been, like, you know, reading it, doing prayers and everything. Mm-hmm. I think you should take a look at it.
Awesome. Thank you, man.
Because it can help you in your ways of life, too. And you can get closer to God. By praying.
I'll give you a shot, man. Appreciate it.
That's good.
Thank you, man.
Thank you, man.
Hey, how you doing, man?
Hey, what's up, man?
You know where nephew
is? Yeah, he's in the computer's room.
Cool.
Hey, what's the song, bro? Oh, it's called Loaded to the End. By a Christian rapper, and I'm reading my Bible.
Okay, bro, cool, bro. Yeah. Sorry to interrupt you, bro. This Bible, man.
What's wrong with the Bible?
Man, it helped me, bro.
It did.
Dude,
That's good.
I did my prayers, man. I read the Bible. I felt love, man. I felt Jesus' love, man. I think we should spread the gospel, dude. Because I want other people to feel that love.
I think I have an idea how to do that. Like, I'm working on seeking us and sharing the gospel, too. How about putting it around the campus, and I feel like doing this, spreading the gospel around school, like putting Jesus verses on it, it can help a lot of people change.
That's awesome, bro. Can I join with you?
Yeah, man.
Awesome, bro. Appreciate it.
2, 3.
All right, man. I got a sticky note. All
right. I got some, too. I got a lot.
All right.
You got more? Yeah.
Awesome. All right. I think we should put it near a classroom where, like, you know, kids can see it. All right.
Like in front of a door or something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe, hey. I have an area, bro.
You do?
Yeah.
This right here, dude? This passage?
It's right next to the door.
All right. There
so
we go.
So when they try to walk in the class, bro, see everyone walk in class.
We'll definitely see that.
Yes, sir.
All right, what's another spot?
Hey, how about the door right here?
All right. I'm gonna put it in front of this one.
Awesome, a lot of people see that one for sure.
Alright.
You have one more?
They have to get into it, you know. They have to see those notes, too. Alright,
I think one more.
Alright. Thank you, man, for this bro. This really filled my life. Hey, man. You gotta save people, man. We're all brothers and sisters.
Can I take
that one?
Yeah. Cool, appreciate it.
What's right here? Yeah,
rent
the buffet.
Awesome, man. Appreciate it. Really.
يعني تمللنا تمللنا ولا نومنا نوم ولا قعدتنا قعدة ولا أكلنا أكل. يعني بأي لحظة خايفين قاعدين إحنا وأطفالنا وخايفين بأي لحظة يشيتون علينا.
We're here today, as you know, with Chula Vista Learning Charter, and we're at the Associated General Contractors Apprenticeship and Training Facility in Lakeside, and we've got 60 high school students that are going through career exploration today, and they're doing wood framing, metal stud framing, they're seeing some drone technology and how drone applies to construction. We've got heavy equipment simulators, and we have some plumbing for them, and then we're doing some little trivia contest. So they're having a lot of fun, and they're going to walk away today with a much better perspective of what their careers could look like and their career opportunities in construction.
Well, I already learned the basics of plumbing, which I did not know anything by yesterday. I'm learning a lot today, so I'm open to anything, really. I think I would be into the drones because I like technology. And I've used drones before, so I'm really into that type of technology, so I'm looking forward to that.
There's a lot of woodworking and a lot of metalworking and all that kind of stuff, so it's pretty interesting. You can make a lot of things with just wood, like birdhouses or a bench or a desk or a table. You know, it's fun. I do want to see how forklifts work, or I'm not sure if this is part of this specific program, but it would be pretty cool to see how they work. I just want to explore and see what horizons this place can open up for me.
Right now we have about between 55 and 60 employees. It varies because it depends on how many classes that we're teaching. That will vary throughout the months of the year. To enter the field as an apprentice, you can go to one of our contractor members and look to be hired there, or you can come here at the AGC apprenticeship. You can sign up. When you do that, you get put on a waiting list, and whenever contractors need somebody, we just go down the list in order. So eventually you get called to go out to get the work. So the apprentices work during the day, make a very, very high wage, and then at 5 o'clock at night they come to take classes two nights a week.
We teach 7 different trades at our training facility here, and they include carpenters, cement masons, laborers, equipment operators, painters, steel stud and drywall, and drywall finishing. My best advice would be to find something that you enjoy doing, because if you enjoy doing it, you're always going to want to learn more, and it's fun.
What we do at Workforce Connect is we actually have students come out and do career exploration. So in lieu of employees, we have a group we built an ecosystem of different companies, so industry, education, and community. And we bring those partners together, and we put on career exploration days as you're seeing here today. So we have about 60 students here today. And we try to do a career exploration day. We have several a month here at the AGC apprenticeship. When you want to get into the trades in the industry, they are pre-apprenticeship and apprenticeship programs. So those are in lieu of a college degree. So when you go into an apprenticeship program, they are actually paid training programs. So you work while you're in the program and you don't accrue college debt. So it's a win-win. So after 4 years, you are experienced journeyman in a trade, and you've earned money while you're training, and you have no college debt.
I'm the mayor of the city of Chula Vista.
We have several students, 59 of them, coming down to look at the apprenticeship program for the AGC, and I wanted to come and support them. Many students are going to be college bound, but there are other students that may not want to do college, and we want to show them that there are opportunities to have careers and trades and to be able to go to an apprentice program where they can learn those trades. They can actually make just as much money and maybe even more as somebody with a college education. So Chula Vista is a very dynamic city. We have three major projects on our bayfront. We have the Gaylord Project, the Pacifica Project, and the Bayview Project. It's over $4.5 billion of investment in our bayfront. It's gonna be creating over 3,000 jobs in the trades. And this is gonna be an opportunity for many people to get in and have a great career for the next several years. In addition, Chula Vista is a fast-growing city. We're at 277,000 people, but in the next 10 years, we're gonna be over 300,000, and that's gonna create a lot of jobs and a lot of opportunity for people with trades. Why do trades matter? Because we wanna make sure that we're growing a great community, and then also redeveloping older parts of our community. When you have your roads, you have to continue to maintain them because you'll get potholes, you get other things. And you want to be able to learn these trades because it helps create the quality of life and improves the quality of life for your community.